I take great pride in introducing the charming 18th century romantic ballad, A Frog He Would A Wooing Go. Go.
A frog he would a woo and go, hey ho, Saroli, whether his mother would let him or no, with a roly poly gammon and spinach, hey ho, Saroli.
Beautiful.
Thank you, sir. He came to sweet Miss Mousie's hall, hey ho, Saroli. He gave a loud knock and he gave a loud call with a roly poly.
And double those great men to hold your hand, hey, Roly. Charming.
Thank you. Thanks, but while they there were merrymaking, hey ho, said Rolly, a cat and her kittens came tumbling in with a roly
poly coming and allow that Anthony Rolly. Oh, yes, sheer poetry, isn't it?
Well, I think I'd like it more if I understood the words.
Oh, well, which words?
Well, let's start with a frog he would a wooing go.
Aha! Uh-huh. Yes, that. This shows us that there was a time when frogs indeed used to go woo.
Frogs don't go woo-woo, they go ribbit.
Only very recently.
Hey, who said Anthony Rowley?
Oh, yes, that one. The precise meaning of the expression, hey ho, is lost in antiquity. You won't find any modern rubbish here.
With a roly-poly, gammon, and spinach?
Oh, yes.
What's that?
That's rubbish.
That's what I thought.